For the balancing of a chemical reaction, how many moles of a reactant is participated? How many moles of a reactant is formed? How many moles of reactant is formed? How many moles of reactant is consumed? For any chemical reaction, the number of moles involved is always equals to the number of moles product formed. This is known as simple law of conservation of mass or law of conservation of energy. So therefore, to balance the chemical equations, some chemical calculations are required. Such chemical calculations are known as stoichiometric equations. Means, if a given chemical reaction is completely balanced with respect to reactants and products, is always known as stoichiometric equation. For example, a simple example of stoichiometric equation: when magnesium react with hydrochloric acid to form magnesium chloride, and loss of which takes place, H2 takes place. This is an acid, a salt is formed along with the liberation of which one? Hydrogen gas. Now here is 2 moles of chlorines are formed, but here is what? 1 chlorine. Here is 2 hydrogens are liberated, but here is what? 1 hydrogen, 1 magnesium. So therefore, to balance this particular equation, how many moles of this is required? 2 moles of hydrochloric acid is required. So from reactant side and product side, all the atoms are satisfied. In a stoichiometric ratio. Which ratio? Stoichiometric ratio. So this type of equation is known as stoichiometric equation. This particular process is known as what? Stoichiometry. This is the first one. For example, a double decomposition reaction. When a beryllium chloride react with sulfuric acid, when beryllium chloride react with sulfuric acid, so this part comes here, this part goes here like this, then comes like this. Okay, it is an example of which one? Double decomposition reaction. Now here is barium and sulfate, it forms barium sulfate. What is this? Barium sulfate plus hydrochloric acid is formed. Now here is 2 chlorines, 2 hydrogens, 1 sulfate ion, 1 barium. It is balanced. But which are not balanced? The hydrogens are not balanced. From reactant side, 2 hydrogens here. From chlorines also here is 2, but here is 1. So therefore, then a third balancing equation, like a simple balancing equation like N2 gas reacts with hydrogen gas to form NH3 gas. Which gas is formed? Ammonia gas is formed. Now here is 2 nitrogens, Here is what, only two hydrogens, two hydrogens here, here is what, two nitrogens, but here is what, three hydrogens. Suppose if I put two here, two twos are four, here is three, no use. If I took here is three, three twos are six, six hydrogens here, two nitrogens, so therefore, if I put two here is, two threes are six hydrogens, two nitrogens, so therefore, this is which one? A balanced chemical equation. So therefore, in a chemical reaction, in a particular chemical reaction, the stoichiometric ratio of atoms of reactants and same stoichiometric ratio of products are formed. So such reactions are known as what? Stoichiometric equations are balanced chemical equations. Now, before going to discuss about law of chemical combinations, so first we need to discuss some basics related to this, like atomic number, atomic weight, molecular mass, okay, so mole concepts. So these are the basics which are required in order to understand properly what is that stoichiometry. So in that, the first one is atomic number, one is atomic mass, number one is atomic mass, molecular mass and mole concept. After this, I will discuss which one, law of chemical combination. After that, concentration terms. After that, we go for which one, balancing of chemical equation. This is a one of the process to discuss this particular chapter to understood easily, So the first one is mass number. Now, so before going to discuss about mass number, we need some information about atoms. Generally, atoms are indivisible. Atoms are which one? Indivisible small or indivisible particle of a matter. The indivisible particle of a matter is known as atom. Now, first we go for the some of the important concepts related to Dalton's atomic theory or Dalton's theory. According to this particular theory, the indivisible, particles of a matter is known as atom. Indivisible means there is no division of that particular particle. It is the smallest portion. It is a smallest portion of matter. What is that? Smallest portion of matter known as atom. Smallest portion of a matter is known as atom. Matter means anything has occupies mass and space. Anything has occupies which one? Mass and space known as matter. For example, when we took this particular blackboard, this blackboard contains some space. It occupies which one? Some space. And it has a specific mass, means it has a particular mass. Maybe 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg, like that. So that is the reason why this is known as a matter. Blackboard is generally taken as a matter. So example is, diamond is a matter, graphite is a matter. When we discuss about our chemistry side, diamond, silicon, carbon, okay, graphite, zinc, so all these are known as what? Every chemical substance. Every chemical substance belongs to which one? Matter. So therefore, according to Dalton's theory, which theory? According to Dalton's concept, the indivisible particle of a matter is known as atom. Atoms are take part in a chemical reaction. Which are involved in a chemical reaction? The smallest particle which is involved in a chemical reaction. Every chemical reaction is participated by a smallest particle, that is an atom. So that is the reason why atoms are takes part in a chemical reaction. This is the for the first postulate of which one? Dalton's theory. Coming to the second postulate of Dalton's theory, means the group of combination of same atoms, the group of combination of same atoms to form element. What is element? Element means group of same atoms. Suppose nitrogen. Nitrogen is an element. How we can consider it has a group of same nitrogen atoms? Which atoms? Same nitrogen atoms present in it. So that is the reason why group of the combination, the group of combination of same atoms are known as elements. Due to same group of atoms, due to same group of atoms, element contains, every element contains a particular mass, means specific mass as well as specific properties. It has a own properties. Nitrogen is, the nitrogen element chemical properties are different from oxygen element, because oxygen combination atoms are different from nitrogen atoms combination. So that is the reason why, so every element has a unique properties. Every element has what? Unique properties, means a particular mass and particular properties. This is the second postulate of which one? Because whenever an atom is discovered by scientist, so Dalton discovered about an atom, then he was explained some concepts, how atoms are formed, how elements are formed, how they are combined, how compounds are formed.